22nd जनवरी इज नॉट जस्ट ओनली गोइंग टू बी प्राण प्रतिष्ठा एंड कॉन्सेक्रेशन ऑफ श्री राम लला इन अयोध्या टेम्पल, इट ऑल्सो हैज सेंड ओपोजिशन पार्टीज इन अ पॉलिटिकल फ्रेंजी एंड कन्फ्यूजन. When we talk about Congress, it has declined to participate in temple ceremony, saying that it goes against their political ideology of secularism. In fact, Jawaharlal Nehru disapproved the presence of Sri Rajendra Prasad during inauguration of Somnath Mandir, saying that religion is a personal matter and state dignitaries should not be present at such events. On the other hand, Congress has given a justification that in fact Shankaracharyas have also not liked the decision of consecration of Ram Mandir because according to them temple work has not been completed and temple consecration has been made as a politicized move. But Congress on one hand says that religion is a political matter and on another hand they are giving justification from the viewpoint of Shankaracharyas, which runs counterintuitive. Secondly, when we talk about opposition bloc, that is India bloc, there also there is a lot of confusion. On one hand, Uddhav Thackeray's political party says that they should be given the credit for Ram Mandir because they were the chief architects of Ram Janmabhoomi movement. On another hand, if we see Udayanidhi Stalin of DMK, he says that he outrightly opposes Supreme Court judgment how a temple can be constructed where there was a mosque. On third front, Aam Aadmi Party's Arvind Kejriwal has started recitation of Sundar Kand in Delhi. At the same time, Sharad Pawar and Akhilesh Yadav, they say that they will visit temple but not on 22nd of January. So there is a lot of confusion and there is an utter lack of coherence in opposition bloc. Also within the Congress, one section wants to take the credit. They say that it was during the time of Rajiv Gandhi that temple doors were opened, and also during the Rajiv Gandhi's time, Shilanyas happened in the temple. On another hand, there is one group within the Congress which is preaching their secularistic ideology. So there seems to be a lot of confusion, and BJP by inaugurating the temple has completed the phase one of their Hindutva agenda. Now, if Congress or the opposition wants to preach themselves as a contender in 2024 elections, they cannot afford such kind of incoherence. They need to keep forward a credible opposition. So that is my viewpoint on this particular development. Thank you so much.